Hello everybody, welcome to my 41st vlog. Yes, 41. I should have done this vlog last night, but I went to the movies last night and I got home like around midnight, ate dinner, and by the time I got up to my room here, it was almost 1 in the morning and I didn't feel like doing the video. Sorry. I was tired, I had worked all day, and my feet hurt quite bad actually. Like I said, I went to the movie last night. I saw a movie called Nocturnal Animals, directed by Tom Ford. And I'll probably have a review of that a little later. But let's just say, a little bit disappointed, but that's about it. I'll do a better review when I do the actual review, you know, because I want to do one. So at my job, right, it was a little bit busy. People are very nervous because we are having a corporate visit. And I'm not, you know, I had to get a lot of stuff done. I had to clean up a lot of stuff, and I got all my stuff done in record time, which is good. And we got to leave a half an hour early. So at my job, everyone's on edge. I don't understand why. People are always so nervous around corporate people. They're scared to get yelled at. They're scared to be put down or whatever. But to me, corporate people do not scare me. They're just people, you know. They're not these weird, crazy, angelic beings. They're not nothing supernatural. They're just folks who somehow got lucky and got to work at a job that has them behind a desk or flying around the country or whatever bullshit they gotta do. If people seem to think that corporate people have the power to fire you for no reason whatsoever, not really, not really. This is not 1987, you know. This is 2016. There are a ton of laws in place that there has to be a reason or they can get sued. Plain and simple. So I don't fear corporate stuff. When I worked at Staples, we would go crazy, clean up the place, get everything perfect for a visit over a span of a week or two. And by the time, the entire corporate visit will last 7 minutes. It's happened to me before, you know. Especially when the president of Staples visited our store. It was horrific, man, absolutely fucking horrific. That we went all crazy trying to get the store perfect, and the guy didn't even fucking look at our store. He didn't even look at my department. I didn't even meet him. So good, you know. So other than that, you know, it was an okay day. It went by a little bit fast. I walked quite a bit yesterday, including the trip to the movies. I walked almost 17,000 steps, almost. Which is about 7 miles or so, 6 or 7 miles. And right now, the sole of my foot is fucking aching badly, and not in a good way. It hasn't alleviated. I'm taking pain pills right now, and I hope it's better by tomorrow. It has to be better by tomorrow. I have no choice. I'm not gonna call out sick. It's gonna look very fucking suspicious if I call out tomorrow. And besides, calling out tomorrow is not really it's not really something I can do I have to close and I have to wait for the cleaners to do their cleaning stuff, you know. I have Wednesday off, which is good. Probably gonna take my grandmother to see the movie that day. We're probably gonna go see Mona or Moana, whatever the fuck you say. And yeah, I was gonna take her to see Fantastic. Ooh, scratched something back in there. Hurt. I have so much pain today. I was taking her to go see Moana. I was thinking about taking her to see Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them, and I don't know. Looks okay to me, but it could be kind of meh, though, too. Yesterday was just, I don't know, it was an okay day. And it was a Sunday, and it was raining during the morning time. It was one of those days where you didn't want to be outside. And it seemed to me like the first 3 hours took forever to get there, you know, to pass, you know? And not only that, but, like, the mid-shift, I think, is probably the worst shift because it takes a long time to get the momentum going, and then 11 to 7:30 just seems like such a long fucking time, you know. It seems, I mean, even though the same amount of time, it just seems longer. 2 to 10:30 doesn't seem as long as 11 to 7:30 or 10 to 6:30 or 12 to 8:30. 12 to 8:30 is probably worse because it's one of those things again where there's not much time in the morning to do anything, and there's not much time to do anything at night either. I mean, you could probably go out, but you know, if you have to work the next day, what's the point of going out, you know? That's really about it, you know? I don't know. Yesterday I went to Burger King, you know? It was really, really good, to be honest. I thought I was going to hate it. I thought I was going to get a stomachache because I haven't had it in a long, long time in terms of dinner time and stuff. my God, it was delicious. I don't know why people talk shit about it, man, but that's, the place tastes fucking delicious, man. I mean, this bacon burger thing, and man, it was good. The fries were good. You know, I went to the weird Burger King in downtown San Francisco on Powell Street, and it was nice, you know? Really, really good. And it felt good, you know? Then after that, I went to the movies. The movie, the theater I went to was called the Century 9. And it's downtown, kind of a snide theater, but there's only like 3 or 4 people on the entire screen. And it was a big screen too, which is kind of cool. And so there's that, you know. And it was something that was kind of earned, you know. Sometimes there's something magical about going to the movies after work, even though you're tired, your body aches, but you've earned that movie time, you know. Originally, I was thinking about going in the morning time, but I don't want to do that no more, you know. Today, I wanted to stay at home. I wanted to work on videos, so there's that. I also got kicked out of a Facebook group yesterday. Apparently, I posted a movie review when I wasn't supposed to, and I befriended a friend that this guy that the main admin hated. So there's that. But so weird, man. I didn't realize there was gonna be so many fucking rules to join a pseudo collecting group. It's a fucking weirdos and losers, man, collecting toys after the age of 40. Yes, I collect clothes. Yes, I collect Blu-rays, but nah, I don't collect toys, action figures, and that crap. And I tried to talk to the guy sensibly, and he came off as a fucking weirdo. Brandon or Brian or whatever the fuck his name is. Fuck him, you know. I actually feel kind of good to be out of that group because, I don't know, they just... a bunch of funky people. That's why I don't really like pop culture that much. That's why I try to stay away from like cons, comic cons, those kind of things. That's why I try for a long time try to stay away from these pops, you know, because I know that communities that follow them are not very nice. They're very snarky and very funky and very weird, and I don't like that, you know. It's a hobby of mine, you know. It's a hobby of mine that, you know, I have a woman, you know, her name is Wendy. She's Chinese and stuff, you know. She's from China. And in terms of hobbies, me and her have hardly any hobbies in common, which is good. I like that style, you know. We can do our thing and be happy, you know. We can do our thing and not have to worry about it, you know, trying to please one or the other. The only thing we do have in common, though, ironically, right, is we love watching TV. That's one of our biggest things. Everywhere we go, we gotta watch TV. And she's down just to kick it at home, you know. She loves kicking it at home. Sometimes I try to get her to go out, she doesn't want to go out. Sometimes she wants me to go out, I don't want to go out. But we're both happy at home, you know. Oftentimes we're just happy like that, you know. We do like going to the movies, though, that's one thing. And we do occasionally like going out to like maybe drink, not so much dancing, but we like to go to bars. We went to a couple bars when I was back there in Nanning last this year, and it was pretty fun, you know. She's pretty chill. She's not a late night gal either. I mean, we used to stay out late, probably like 1 a.m, but those bars go on till dawn, so we didn't do super late. So yeah, so now I don't have much more of a forum to put my videos on anymore, which is okay. It's okay. I'd rather just do it through Facebook or, you know, Twitter and stuff like that, you know. Hopefully they, you guys appreciate my videos and stuff. But yeah, I never post any vlog videos on there, only my movie reviews, because I thought when I reviewed the Spirit, it would be the same kind of spirit of stuff that they liked, because, you know, they like collecting those old comics and that kind of stuff, but apparently not. Apparently not, so fuck them, you know. Anyways, yeah, that's pretty about it, guys. I just got a package in the mail, which is good. I'm gonna see, maybe I might do an unboxing of that, and maybe I'm definitely gonna do the review of Nocturne Animals. Not quite sure how I'm gonna do it yet, but I'm still thinking about it. But yeah, if you guys like my video, please like, please subscribe, and I'll talk to you guys later.